good morning, everybody, and welcome to another Coffee and Devotions with Adam. I'm Adam, this is my coffee, and it's time for some devotions this morning. I got a lot to cover, so I want to get right to it this morning, okay? I was talking to one of my, well, he's still part of the youth group. He's just, he's attending college elsewhere. His name is Daniel. Daniel, if you're watching, what's up, my man? We miss you. Hurry back home. Anyway, so we were talking just kind of talking about like the existence of God, and I got to thinking about Easter season, and you know, this is the Easter season, right? We got all this stuff coming up. Easter Sunday is going to be coming real soon, and I started thinking, how many people really are missing out on like what Easter really means? You know, like they've just kind of lost the whole point of Easter, and it's become commercialized. You know, Easter Bunny and chocolates and all that stuff. You know, it's like the commercialization of Easter. Well, I wanted to kind of think about some of the stuff, okay? Like, we're missing out on the fact that Jesus Christ came back from the dead, that there was an incredible, world-changing, history-altering event that happened 2,000 years ago on a Sunday morning that changed everything for us. And make no mistake, I mean, Jesus came back from the dead. And there were a few facts that I want to go over with you. I just want to throw them out there for you so you guys can have this stuff, man. And you can tell people. And you can go with it. So let's think about this, okay? Jesus was put in the tomb. The body of Jesus was in the tomb on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. All right? But just a little while later, the two-ton stone that was sitting in front of the tomb, that was sealed with the Roman imperial seal on both sides, that seal was broken, and that stone, the two-ton stone, was rolled uphill and away from the tomb, showing an empty tomb. So the first question was like, who moved the stone, right? The Roman guards? Not likely. You know that there were guards posted there, right? I mean, that's a historical fact that it says that there were guards posted there. Well, if anything had happened to that seal or that stone under the guards' charge, those guards were to be burned to death. Okay, that was their sentence. Now, we're not talking like two guards or three guards here. I don't know if you know this, but there were four squads of up to 16 Roman soldiers that were guarding that. 24 hours a day, 365 and a quarter days a year, they were charged to guard that stone to death to defend it. Okay? So, do you think four squads of 16 soldiers were completely and totally suicidal? I doubt it. So then what about the disciples? Sure, they come out of hiding, overpower those best trained soldiers in the whole wide world, roll a two-ton stone uphill, and then steal the body. I don't think so. So who moved the stone? The answer, guys, lies in Matthew chapter 28, verses 2 to 4. He says, suddenly there was a great earthquake because an angel of the Lord came down from heaven and rolled aside the stone and sat on it. His face shone like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. The guards shook with fear when they saw him, and they fell into a dead faint. So why did the angel roll the stone away? Well, it was easy, to show the world that the body was gone and that Jesus was back from the dead. So then the next question is, where'd the body go? Maybe Jesus' enemies took the body, right? That way they could help fulfill the prophecy that they hated so much, that they could help Jesus fulfill everything that he said, right? Sure, that's what they did. Wrong. Besides, if his enemies took the body, then why did they stay silent when the disciples started telling everybody about the resurrection of Jesus Christ? All they would have had to do is bring the body of Jesus out, parade it around in front of everybody, and say, ha, liars, we got his body right here. Christians all aren't a bunch of wackos, right? So maybe the friends of Jesus took it. Again, let's think of this scene. Here are these untrained fishermen, tax collectors, overpowering these trained killing machines. They roll a two-ton stone away up the hill, steal the body, hide it, and then go on to preach lies to everybody, to everyone and everything. Preach to the point that they actually die for something that they know is not true. Every single one of them. Guys, if you examine all of the options, there really is only one option. Jesus came back from the dead. He was who he says he was. He's alive and well, even as we're talking right now. And as you're watching this video, he's alive. He appeared to his disciples and then to over 500 people. Did you know that if you took all of the people that Jesus appeared to, that you read about in 1 Corinthians 15:6, if you took all those people and you talked to every single one of them for 15 minutes and listened to their story for only 15 minutes, mind you, and you never took a break and you went around the clock with them, you would talk to people for over 5 days about their firsthand personal experience with Jesus Christ. Many of these people were still alive when that story of the resurrection had gone around the known world. So if you were one of those people that thought it was a lie, all you had to do was go and talk to the people that had actually walked with Jesus after his death. So the bottom line is, guys, that people who do not believe in the resurrection of Christ simply do not want to believe. Now, and I'm only scratching the surface of the facts, guys. I'm trying to cram this in shortly for you. But these people remind me of that person whose life motto is the one that says, "I've made up my mind, so please do not confuse me with the facts." Well, listen, the fact is that if you accept the resurrection of Jesus Christ for the fact that it is, you have absolutely no choice but to choose heaven or hell. And you do not have the luxury of choosing not to choose. So what does the resurrection mean to me? What does Easter mean to me? In a word, simple. Victory. You see, death has been defeated. The way to heaven has been opened wide for me because Jesus broke that seal and rolled the stone. So this season, this Easter season, go out and share that story with somebody. Tell somebody what Easter means to you, what Easter really stands for. And let's forget the bunnies and the chocolate. Well, maybe just the bunnies. I like chocolate. Blessings on you guys. Have a blessed week. Find your strength and encouragement in the Lord. Cheers.